Hello everyone, welcome to the fifth video. Here we will discussing about boosting, and from now on we'll cover the boosting part. Okay, so in the first video I talked about the two paradigms in ensembling, that is the parallel form and the sequential form. Parallel form was dedicated to bagging and sequential form is used for boosting. So consider the binary classification problem again. Now we have a weak learning algorithm. Briefly speaking, what a weak learning algorithm is. So suppose any algorithm that gives a classifier that is slightly better than random, that is known as a weak learning algorithm. Say you have certain training data points and certain labels. So consider this algorithm that predicts all the data points as one. So what this has, the probability that this model commits error is equal to 0.5. So weak learning algorithm is basically an algorithm that has an error that is slightly less than 0.5. Now let us define a vector p with elements p1, p2 till pm on the training set x1, y1, x2, y2 till xm, ym, and the distribution of sampling these training points is given by the vector p, where p1 is the probability of sampling the data point x1, y1, and pm is the probability of sampling the data point xm, ym. Moreover, you may note that the sum of all the probabilities for a probability distribution should be equal to 1. Right. Now consider phi j as a weak hypothesis. So, and consider gamma to be greater than 0. Now, as phi j is a weak hypothesis, the error that it performs is slightly less than 0.5. Right. So here you can see that the probability of the hypothesis phi j committing an error, that is yi not equal to phi j xi, that is the predicted label by phi j, is slightly less than 0.5, that is 1 by 2 minus gamma. So we assume that there is some classifier that slightly does better than the random guessing, and then we try to improve this with the following algorithm. Let's move on to the next slide. So let me propose a weak learning algorithm first. As discussed earlier, we input a distribution of probabilities p1, p2 till pm on the training set x1, y1, x2, y2 till xm, ym, and it is normalized. The sum of all the probabilities is equal to 1. So the result of this algorithm is that it returns a weak classifier phi j whose error is slightly less than 0.5. The boosting algorithm can be summarized as, first we try to assign each training example an equal weight, that is equal weight as in the sense 1 by m, as m is the number of training examples. Now we obtain a weak hypothesis that does well on the current weights on the training examples, and as it is a weak hypothesis, the error is quite high. It may be less than 0.5, but it is quite high. So we need to reweight the training examples, like we need to change the probability distribution of sampling the data from the training examples. How this is done? In the second model, we give more weightage to the training points that are misclassified by the previous model. So we increase the weight of the misclassified points and then again sample the data for the next model. So as you can see that the second model is trying to predict, trying to do better on the misclassified points. So as you can also observe that we are boosting the first model into the second one, right? So the second model will try to do better than the first model, and similarly it will go on, and we perform this repeatedly till we get a good classifier. Okay, so we come to the end of this video. In the next video we will look at a specific algorithm, that is AdaBoost, and look into the mathematical details of it.